Hello, welcome to SourceFED, I'm Joe Beretta. Conditions in the Mississippi River in the Wisconsin region were perfect earlier this week for the annual emergence of the mayfly, a delicate dance dedicated to rising from the mighty Mississippi as one gigantic horny swarm to take to the sky and make sweet, sweet love, lay eggs, and die. Tis the tragic, sexy life of the mayfly. These little buggers spend up to 4 years developing underwater, munching on plant and algae stuffs, until they rocket through insect puberty, sprout wings, and accept a mission to boogie and die. Adult mayflies live for one day, knock boots, and then they're done. No more existence. No awkward next morning, no, is she gonna call me? Just sexy, sexy death. And oh, bonus, they have two penises and two gonopores, so it's like sex squared. The massive flying death orgy is a natural yearly occurrence that is as expected as spring's first fragile flower or winter's first gently falling flake. Except, this is all sorts of messy and gross and huge. This year's swarm was big enough to be considered a major emergence. And their sexcapades were so colossal and vast that they lit up weather radar screens like it was Christmas. Sex Christmas. The swarm was thick. And on July 20th, La Crosse, Wisconsin was treated to quite the show, courtesy of these insectabitionists. The mayflies coated walls, streetlights, gas stations, ATMs, roadways, and everything as they quested for mates and diddled. Male mayflies die right after ejaculation. Best orgasm ever. Or worst, and their carcasses are everywhere. The ladies quickly find a water source, squirt out some offspring, and die. In 2012, the body count was so high they enlisted the snowplow brigade to clean things up. This year, at least one car accident was attributed to slick conditions created by the mayfly jelly smeared all over roadways. Now, although this may send the heebie-jeebies crawling through your body spots, this momentary inconvenience to humans is actually a really good thing. A great swarm is an indicator of healthy water conditions. If mayfly counts are low, it's a sign that pollution levels are high. Animals also love when the mayfly cult takes flight to drink the sex Kool-Aid because it's an all-you-can-eat buffet of biblical proportions. So, nature's cool, y'all. It's really cool. You know what? It's too bad because when I was a kid, I found a VHS tape of some guy doing like a performance art piece of the life cycle of the mayfly, and I wish I could show it to you, but I can't. I don't know why I brought it up. So instead of me showing you that, why don't you guys in the comments down below create a little mayfly poem about the love cycle and the life cycle of the mayfly, and I'll read it and I will indulge in it, and it'll be just for me. After that, please like the video, subscribe to the channel, and click the annotation for more SourceFED. I am Joe Beretta, and before you go, I have a little bit of wordplay for you. What did the male mayfly say to the female mayfly after they consummated their relationship? Nothing, because he was f***ing dead.